In 1921, Nicola Sacco and Bartolomeo Vanzetti, both Italian-Americans, were convicted of robbery and murder. Although the arguments brought against them were mostly disproved in court, the fact that the two men were known radicals, and that their trial took place during the height of the Red Scare, prejudiced the judge and jury against them. Nicola Sacco was born on April 22, 1891, and Bartolomeo Vanzetti was born on June 11, 1888. They were Italian immigrant anarchists who were controversially convicted of murdering a guard and a paymaster during the April 15, 1920, armed robbery of the Slater and Morial Shoe Company in Braintree, Massachusetts, United States. Sacco was a shoemaker and a night watchman, born in Torre Maggiore, province of Foggia, Apulia region, Italy, who migrated to the United States at the age of 17. Before immigrating, Sacco worked on his father's vineyard, often sleeping out in the field at night to prevent animals from destroying the crops. Vanzetti was a fishmonger in Villa Fileto, province of Cuneo, Piedmont region. Both left Italy for the U.S. in 1908, although they did not meet until a 1917 strike. In November 1925, Celestino Medeiros, an ex-convict awaiting trial for murder, confessed to committing the Braintree crimes. He absolved Sacco and Vanzetti of participation. In May, once the SJC had denied their appeal and Medeiros was convicted, the defense investigated the details of Medeiros' story. Police interviews led them to the Morelli gang based in Providence, Rhode Island. They developed an alternative theory of the crime based on the gang's history of shoe factory robberies, connections to a car like that used in Braintree, and other details. Gang leader Joe Morelli bore a striking resemblance to Sacco. Orsani was arrested May 6th, but gave the alibi that he had been at work on the day of both crimes. Sacco had been at work on the day of the Bridgewater crimes, but said that he had the day off on April 15th, the day of the Braintree crimes, and was charged with those murders. The self-employed Vanzetti had no such alibis and was charged for the attempted robbery and attempted murder in Bridgewater and the robbery and murder in the Braintree crimes. Sacco and Vanzetti were charged with the crime of murder on May 5, 1920, and indicted 4 months later on September 14th. Following Sacco and Vanzetti's indictment for murder for the Braintree robbery, Gallianists and anarchists in the United States and abroad began a campaign of violent retaliation. 2 days later on September 16, 1920, Mario Buda allegedly orchestrated the Wall Street bombing, where a time-delayed dynamite bomb packed with heavy iron sash weights in a horse-drawn cart exploded, killing 38 people and wounding 134. In 1921, a booby-trap bomb mailed to the American ambassador in Paris exploded, wounding his valet. For the next 6 years, bombs exploded at other American embassies all over the world. On April 9, 1927, Judge Thayer heard final statements from Sacco and Vanzetti. In a lengthy speech, Vanzetti, "I would not wish to a dog or to a snake, to the most low and misfortunate creature of the earth, I would not wish to any of them what I have had to suffer for things that I am not guilty of. But my conviction is that I have suffered for things that I am guilty of. I am suffering because I am a radical, and indeed I am a radical. I have suffered because I am an Italian, and indeed I am an Italian. If you could execute me 2 times, and if I could be reborn 2 other times, I would live again to do what I have done already. On April 9, 1927, Sacco and Vanzetti's final appeal was rejected, and the two were sentenced to death. Felix Frankfurter, then a professor at Harvard Law School, was considered to be the most prominent and respectable critic of the trial. He was appointed to the Supreme Court by Franklin Delano Roosevelt in 1939. Thayer declared that the responsibility for the conviction rested solely with the jury's determination of guilt. The court has absolutely nothing to do with that question. He sentenced each of them to suffer the punishment of death by the passage of a current of electricity through your body. During the week beginning July 10th, he twice postponed the execution date while the governor considered requests for clemency. The executions were scheduled for midnight between August 22nd and 23, 1927. On August 15th, a bomb exploded at the home of one of the Dedham jurors. On Sunday, August 21st, more than 20,000 protesters assembled on Boston Como. Sacco and Vanzetti awaited execution in their cells at Charlestown State Prison, and both men refused a priest several times on their last day, as they were atheists. Their attorney William Thompson asked Vanzetti to make a statement opposing violent retaliation for his death, and they discussed forgiving one's enemies. Thompson also asked Vanzetti to swear to his and Sacco's innocence one last time, and Vanzetti did. Celestino Medeiros, whose execution had been delayed in case his testimony was required at another trial of Sacco and Vanzetti, was executed first. Sacco was next and walked quietly to the electric chair, then shouted, "Farewell, mother." Vanzetti, in his final moments, shook hands with guards and thanked them for their kind treatment, read a statement proclaiming his innocence, and finally said, "I wish to forgive some people for what they are now doing to me." Following the executions, death masks were made of the men. Violent demonstrations swept through many cities the next day, including Geneva, London, Paris, Amsterdam, and Tokyo. In South America, wildcat strikes closed factories. 3 died in Germany, and protesters in Johannesburg burned an American flag outside the American embassy. It has been alleged that some of these activities were organized by the Communist Party. At Longoni Funeral Home in Boston's North End, more than 10,000 mourners viewed Sacco and Vanzetti in open caskets over 2 days. At the funeral parlor, a wreath over the caskets announced "In Itis Allora della Vendetta." On Sunday, August 28th, a 2-hour funeral procession bearing huge floral tributes moved through the city. Thousands of marchers took part in the procession, and over 200,000 came out to watch. Police blocked the route, which passed the State House, and at one point mourners and the police clashed. The hearses reached Forest Hills Cemetery where, after a brief eulogy, the bodies were cremated. The Boston Globe called it one of the most tremendous funerals of modern times. Will Hayes, head of the Motion Picture Industry's umbrella organization, ordered all film of the funeral procession destroyed. Sacco's ashes were sent to Torre Maggiore, the town of his birth, where they are interred at the base of a monument erected in 1998. Vanzetti's ashes were buried with his mother in Villa Fileto. Thank you for watching Death Row.